had never considered myself to be all that important. I wanted to avoid being a narcissist. So I was an ordinary man with ordinary dreams. Then one day, I got the news. I was dying of a rare disorder that nobody had ever heard of. The doctors had no treatment. They had no cure. They had nothing. They just told me to go home and die. I reasoned that I still had a wife to be. I thought that she would at least stand by my side. That, too, was about to change.
Get lost.
The woman that I loved so much ran out the door, never to return. And I found myself alone. After my fiancé left, I decided to take him ride on my horse, my faithful mare, Paula. Paula relaxed me. I enjoyed riding her, and she was like a friend to me. I wasn't prepared for what happened next. I noticed how the horse had gotten restless. She was making a lot of loud noises as if she was upset. Then, as I brought her back home, I saw it. I had seen the impossible in the sky, up there, above my ranch. There it was. A flying saucer. A UFO. This was no movie. This was real life. It couldn't be possible, and yet it was. Terrified, I ran back inside to the imagined safety of my patio. Climbing inside, I went to the railing and looked out again, up at the strange disc up in the sky. Now I had to make a choice. Was I going to try to look at this thing more closely, or was I going to hide inside? I decided I would look at it more closely, and as I did, something happened. I went outside, and this is when it began. Suddenly, a beam shot down from the craft. And I felt myself enveloped in it. I wasn't able to move. I couldn't do anything except wait and stand there. I felt a tingling sensation, as if something was happening to me. And then I was gone. I was up in the craft. After pressing the green balls as instructed to do, the craft began to move. And I watched my ranch, everything that I knew, disappearing from beneath me. I was more alone than I had ever been. I didn't know where I was. There was one thing I was certain of. I was headed towards a remarkable adventure. tracks of Mars. And for me, it all started with this simple picture. I was simply attempting to determine whether we were seeing liquid water or something else, just sand. When I noticed some objects in the photo that didn't exactly look natural, such as this object here. But more importantly, this object here, where we have this curved dot, curvature, and it looks like a sunken, buried rectangular object, possibly. I saw that, and I began to get curious, so I started to look around in the photo. I noticed this object over on the left, which is a rectangular object with two holes in it. That was not made by volcanic action. Some of the stones as well appear to be placed there as opposed to being just naturally in place. As I got curiouser and curiouser, I began to look around. At this point in time, I didn't understand fully what I was looking at. I did not understand that we were looking at vegetation here in this photo. In this area, for instance, there's clear and obvious vegetation. The patterns are unmistakable. You see the same thing in the Earth photos. Yet, NASA is quiet about this, and the question is why? They're quiet about it because they don't want you to know. I don't want to turn this into a NASA bashing session. I simply want to point out we are not being told the truth. I looked in the background of the photo, and I saw this mysterious structure in here. Once again, this almost certainly is not natural, and it appears to have rectangular windows. But this was only one photo. Had I gone on to other photos and not noticed anything, I probably would not have thought anything of it. I probably would have abandoned things right there. That was not to be the case, however. And as we will see, there's far, far more than what we've been led to believe. In spirit, soul too, on my WordPress blog, I examined this structure in excruciating detail. What we're seeing here is essentially a plant structure of some type, probably rhizomes growing underneath the ground. At least that's what I've been able to determine. It also may be that this is artificial. But I tend towards the natural explanation of plant vegetation because of what we see up above it. The possible seed pod bears a striking resemblance, actually, to the abdomen of various bee species. But I'm assuming that this is vegetation. It, however, is not some rock sitting on the ground. It's well up off the ground. In fact, we can see what are root structures hanging down in this area. Total silence from the media about this. Total irresponsibility. And another object right here, apparently growing right out of the ground. The classic case of a very small seedling growing out of the ground and totally ignored. And the list goes on. If we go over here, we see two more strange objects. Objects which make no sense. Except that we can see them sitting here. I believe that these are unnatural objects. They're very, very small. what their purpose is and why they're sitting on the ground is only a matter of conjecture. We don't know. Not until we're told the truth. And finally, we go over here to another odd object that apparently has something sticking up off it, lending credence to the idea that this is a plant-based object. All in all, the objects in Spirit Soul 2 are clearly, obviously, not right. Yet we don't hear anything from the media about it. They're dead silent. They won't carry it. Why is that? Because they're not dedicated to the truth. And everything you have to be dedicated to the truth. If you look at this area, you see how the ground is darkened some. That's a classic moss-like pattern. Soil has not been disturbed. So it's unlikely that we're seeing anything but some type of moss. You usually don't see a mixture of different soils like that. And it goes on and on. Up at the top is a strange object. Circular, cylindrical. Has a little top on it. And again, over here, another object. Which does not look like a conventional rock. Apparently, it has some sort of plant growth on top of it. So here we have another case from the early days, where we clearly were not told the truth. By this time, I'm sure that scientists had seen some of these things and then decided that they were all wrong, that the official story was wrong, yet they haven't spoken up. I am speaking up. We're going to progress. Later photos, more sophisticated objects. In this photo from Spirit Soul 4, we see a couple of objects which defy any type of logic. If we look at this object here, we see that it is a cylindrical object, and it is hollow, and has a very thin shell, and it apparently has a rectangular area sticking out of it, right there, where the pointer is. This is not a natural object, and should not be called natural. Now, if we zoom down here, you see a circular raised platform right here, light in color. This type of thing is not all that unusual in the Mars Exploration Rover photos. And here is another object which I have not done model for. Yet it clearly is not natural. It comes down to an open end here and then flares out. That's not the mark of a rock. It also appears to be made of a very smooth, shiny metal. What you're seeing is debris. It could be, possibly, from an American spacecraft. Perhaps the same spacecraft that landed there. We don't know, because NASA is quiet about it. This object here, square, rectangular, kind of open on the top. This is one of the earliest photos, obviously. But there's more. If we examine this photo, see an object with obvious windows. Much of this is being obscured, apparently intentionally, so the public can't get a good look at it. And again, patterns of vegetation where we have what looks like a smudged area, yet with stalks that stick straight up. This is obvious vegetation. Should not be construed as being anything but that. Still, the debunkers continue to lie about it. Why? What's so important? Are they afraid for their jobs? Are they afraid for their livelihoods? That's most likely the scenario. And again, this area appears to be liquid water on the surface of the planet, although it's less clear than what you see in other places. We're just getting started. The architects of Mars will show you things that are beyond belief. From Spirit Soul 4, again, we're going to look at more strange objects. Here we have a half moon shaped object. It's got this almost like a quarter moon shape inside it. And then it sits on these rectangular posts or whatever they are. This is not a natural object by any stretch of the imagination, but it's not the only thing that's in the photo. It's just one of many. Below it, we see what is arguably a pipe sticking up out of the ground. I have found pipes to be somewhat common in Mars photos, although not as common as I'd like them to be. Still, it's unmistakable from a rock or other natural object. Those just don't stick up out of the ground and have a hollow end. Now we're going to take a look at other features. We see a fuzzy area in this area. Something apparently is obscured. My guess is vegetation. Looking down here, a round, very suspicious object. Not necessarily unnatural, but very, very curious. Now we're going to look at something really startling. If you've never seen vegetation on another planet, here's another example of it. In this area, we see a cluster of rocks. We can see a bushiness about them. This is a result of what are probably mosses. There's some sort of vegetation, we don't know exactly what, but the best guess is that we're seeing mosses. Point here is that this planet is alive. That fact has not been told to the American public. That is unacceptable. Now we're going to take a look down here. Here we have some objects. They're rather curious. It appears that they've been stirred up by the rover. They are not rocks. They are metallic in shape and very similar to each other. There's two of them. So we're not seeing rocks. We're seeing metallic objects. This has not been reported in the media. They're derelict in their duties. Still, there's a number of other objects we need to look at. This object, for instance, is round and circular and cylindrical, which probably means it's some sort of a container, perhaps similar to beverage containers on here on the Earth. And again, there's another one. And again, we have a round hollow object sticking out here, which is almost certainly a pipe. The evidence just goes on and on. The evidence is far more than conclusive. Still, all we get is lies from the debunkers. And here's one more container. Once again, cylindrical, sitting on the surface. It bears a striking resemblance to an aluminum can. How can that be when it's sitting on the planet Mars? In the next sequence of videos, we're going to show more of the early objects, including ones that are more sophisticated and more confusing. From Spirit Soul 5 again, we have a strange object which defies rational explanation. Looking at this object, it has a thin shell, loops up over here, it's almost like a half cone. What's inside it is what is curious. It appears to be a mechanism of some sort. Totally unfamiliar. Yet there's no question that this object is extraordinary. Totally glossed over, of course, by the media. They're too busy telling you strange tales about murder trials and who's doing what to who in Hollywood. We don't need that. We need full disclosure. And this is what you're getting tonight, is disclosure. Though I can only tell you a small portion of what I know. I've seen far more than I will ever see. This object, strange as it may seem, like I said, appears to have a sophisticated mechanism inside it. Why is it sitting on the Martian desert? We don't know. We have more questions than answers. And the possible leaf is sitting right there, right in front of it. This is not fantasy, folks. This is reality. Mars is alive. It has artifacts on it. It has structures. It may even have intelligent life. Till we get some answers, we won't know for certain. But we can say that Mars is alive and has artifacts on it. From Spirit Soul 5, another early photo. The guest of honor in this case is a rectangular object with a possible sloped front on the right. And it may well be open on the side. But the most interesting feature of this object is one that proves that it's not natural. The fact that it has a post sticking out of it, the bulb-like structure sitting on the end of the post. That's not a rock. Total silence from the media. And we have some other structured objects here which may or may not be natural. This wasn't all for this photo, however. If we go up here, we can see just barely what apparently is a wall with many holes in it. This is not a flat surface, I don't believe. It is part of a wall which has been broken down over the years. You also see thousands of stalks sticking up. This blurred area where the stalks stick up. That is an indication of plant growth. And again, up at the top of the photo, we see what apparently is artificial objects, many of them, structures, partially obscured by the vegetation, and partially obscured by the poor quality of the photo. But they're definitely there. You have not been told the truth, and I'm going to say this again and again. This is not laughing time. This is time to get very, very angry. And again, another anomaly up here, which apparently is part of a structure. Small stacks sticking up. This is the type of thing that is not even mentioned. This is inexcusable. We cannot allow this to continue. But we're just getting started with Architects of Mars. An example of evidence that hasn't been shown to the public comes from Spirit Soul 6. Now if we look at this, there apparently is a series of structures here with very tiny windows. They stretch across the picture at least halfway. And we have what is apparently a large scoop of some kind. I found this to be fairly typical in these hollow objects that sit on the Martian surface. I call them vent hoods. But the most interesting object, and one that really is irrefutable, is this triangular hole in whatever the surface is. Nature certainly didn't create this triangular hole, and that's a fact. This was created by somebody. To think that nature could create a triangular hole in the ground like this is flat out absurd. But, as usual, it's been ignored until now. Hollow objects are a mainstay of Martian photos. There seem to be just oodles of them. So what do we see here? We see yet another hollow object from Spirit Soul 6. Inside the object is a mystery. I'm not 100% certain what we're looking at. Animal, vegetable, mineral, maybe it's manufactured. But it isn't right. This shouldn't be like this. We shouldn't have this hollow object, and it shouldn't have this whatever it is inside it. It appears to be mechanical in nature. Perhaps pipes, because there are two of them. They branch off. One on the right, one on the left. And yet another vine-like object appears to go right across near the top of the inside the hollow shell. So there we have an example of another anomaly that science has not bothered trying to examine or explain. And we have to demand answers. One of these objects will be enough to demand answers. So put away your pizzas and your cell phones and demand answers from your representatives. Look at one more thing from this little clip. A little bit of an odd object down here. These photos are packed full of mysteries, artifacts, and plants. There's no question. And we have to demand the truth. After my ordeal on the phone, I woke up. And I found myself in what appeared to be a crew cabin of some sort. A crew cabin? But where? It appeared that I was in outer space. But I decided to check out the rest of wherever I was before I actually made that determination. This panel said engineering. Engineering of what? Was this a spaceship? Who was the design? Earth didn't have anything like this. We could barely even get off the ground. The transportation and weapons room. What would be the threat out here? Why were there weapons? Where did the transportation go to? Looks like it was probably a control room, and that's exactly what it turned out to be. I decided to go in and investigate. And there it was. Mars. Dead ahead. It appeared that I was orbiting Mars inside an alien spacecraft. Controls were in English, and that didn't make any sense to me. Who were these people? I wanted to go up the ladder to complete my investigation before ever going down to the surface. I want to know exactly what I was facing, if I could find out. A lounge. A very nice one at that. I sat down on the sofa to rest for a minute. This wasn't an unpleasant experience at all. In fact, I was quite enjoying it. But I still didn't know where I was, or what these people wanted, or even if they were people. There was one more room to explore. Here it was. Some sort of a conference room. With symbology similar to that of Earth. And very luxurious chairs. A food dispenser, apparently. Well, I wouldn't starve, at least. Still, I wanted to figure out what was going on. I decided to risk transporting to the surface. Even though I've been told that Mars could not sustain human life, I had assumed that something had been prepared for me to allow me to do this. One thing we've done so far, to some extent, is tended to ignore the opportunity photos a great deal. Always shown as opportunity, soul 17. So we're going to go ahead and show some opportunity photos, the early ones. Here we have opportunity soul 20. It's a very remarkable photo. We have multi-lobed ground cover, very densely covering this area of ground. There's stems and leaves visible everywhere, but interestingly enough, there also appears to be a lattice of pipes going through this area, which makes me wonder if perhaps this is cultivated. Up here in particular, we can see pipe going through with pipes going off it, as if this was something that was designed to irrigate the area. I'm going to adjust back down. Here's a pipe. Goes across and goes down into the ground. We can see this pattern repeated all over this photo of the multi-lobed leaves and stems. And with the pixelation, it's hard to tell. Some of this probably is caused by pixelation. But much of it isn't. Now we're going to go down here, towards the bottom of the photo, and show something really dramatic. Because here we have this in 3D, where it's setting up well up above the surface of the rocks and the ground. So there essentially you have a little bush, if you will, whatever passes for that. On Martian surface. So here we have good, solid evidence of life on another planet. And there is no question. There's nothing to argue about. We're seeing life here. And the remarkable thing in my book is that it's very dense, which means this is quite possibly cultivated. We're going to show some more. I'm going to switch to another video. Since we don't want to ignore opportunity altogether, this is from Opportunity Soul 17. Here we have a photo that shows an obvious object of some sort. I pretty much ruled out the idea that this could be an optical illusion because it seems to cast a shadow right here. I believe it to be a shiny cone mounted on a pole. Perhaps some sort of plumbing fixture. And if you look carefully, you can see small plants sticking up out of the rocks. I mean small plants. There's no other explanation possible. So what does it all mean? Well, let's take a look at the model I created. This model isn't anything special. It's just to illustrate what we are seeing. The original cone is shiny and appears to have a glint of sunlight on it. Mine is kind of dull and sticks out of this rock. But this is a model I made. There is no question, folks. There are artifacts and structures on that planet and plants. Scientific community is lying to us about this. If you just open your eyes and look, you'll see it. And we need people to pressure our representatives and demand the truth. That's the whole basis of what I'm doing. If we can't get them to admit to the truth, we'll show the public ourselves. From Opportunity Soul 23, here we have another example of this. I believe that what we're seeing up here is the airbag, by the way, flattened out on the Martian surface. But in this photo, here we see an incredible pattern of leaves. It's unmistakable. Anybody who thinks you're just seeing rocks or really crazy, actually. Seeing an unmistakable pattern of leaves, and down here we have a dense area. I believe this to be a different type of foliage than what we're seeing up here. Matted type of foliage that you might see on Earth in some places. Whatever it is, it seems to cover the ground very, very densely, once again. And it isn't always easy to tell where the vegetation ends and the ground begins. But we can see all the leaves right up in here. We're going to scoot over and see what else we can find. It's the same basic pattern. Leaves and many, many stems and just a dense pattern of obvious vegetation. Up here we can see how it's kind of fuzzy, which is what you would expect out of a layer of vegetation. When you get towards the top and it starts to thin out. This is actually very thick vegetation. It's amazing that this can just be ignored. And here we have like a root or something. Very fascinating photo. Very, very nice. And this is Opportunity Soul 32. Again, we're seeing the same basic pattern with flat, multi-lobed leaves literally covering this ground in a typical ground cover pattern. But thicker than what you normally expect. I tend to think that these areas are cultivated, but who knows? Well, by who? That's the question. Now we're seeing this in this area, all these tiny little black specks appear to be basically flowers that are up above the surface of the plants. That would be consistent with some sort of a dark flower that would exist there. And here we have a fuzzy layer where you're seeing it on the edge. Once again, this is vegetation where you have a very thick area. You don't get to see the stems much and leaves because of the low resolution. You see a couple of different areas of that. And then you go up higher, we have yet another classic vegetation pattern. So we're showing a number of different vegetation patterns here. I got one more slide in the series to look at. Then we're probably going to take a look at something else. Here on Opportunity Soul 36, we get to see a very thick vegetation pattern once again. But here we can, you know, it's easy to tell that this is sticking up well above the surface of the ground and the surface of the rocks. It's actually growing in the cracks. This is yet another classic vegetation pattern you'd see on Earth. It's actually thicker than what you'd see here on Earth. It may be some sort of a defense mechanism for plants to use to adapt to the Martian surface. We don't know. Here we have plants that are clearly sticking up well above the surface of the ground. They're very finely detailed. There's no possibility whatsoever that we're seeing anything but vegetation. It would be absurd just to sit there and call it a rock when it's not. And again, we have the same pattern again of these strange vegetation ground covers right in here. Very thick. So there we have it. This is some of the things that went on in the early days. And this is probably the first time I've shown this particular sequence of photos. But we can see that this is vegetation that's sticking up. It's not rocks, it's not solid by any means. So there we have really outstanding evidence that there is life on that planet, despite what we've been told, which of course we're told that there can be no life on that planet. You're being lied to, folks, and this is what I'm saying. From Opportunity Soul 49, we have an unusual object which I've just learned to call the creeper. See, it's sticking up here in back of the rock. I believe this to be a small plant with an unusual kind. It seems to be an array sticking up rather than one central stem. But it's not that unusual when compared to some earth plants, so it's only a curiosity as far as I'm concerned. But there's no question that we're looking at a plant or something similar in this case. There's some other unusual objects here before I show one of the main things. We can see these little nodules growing off these rocks. This is a form of life, folks. There's no question. What type of life, I don't know. I've heard this compared with lichens. Here we have one that casts shadow, sticks up like a plant would. There is nothing to argue about here. Again, these may or may not be leaves. I'm going to put those in my gray box for now. Now we're going to look at some more extraordinary things besides these odd nodules that seem to be everywhere and some of them growing in places like this. But we have this unusual object here. As we move the cameras around, I've been unable to identify this. However, it bears a striking resemblance to the object seen in Spirit Soul 2, the one that appeared to have a striped abdomen. And this is striped as well. Could it be that this is some sort of unusual arthropod that's living on Mars? It could very well be. Perhaps the Martian equivalent of an insect. We won't know until we get some truth out of these people. And that's not forthcoming yet, because they don't want to tell us the truth. Right, here we have some more of these nodules that are cast a shadow. So we can tell they're sticking out from the side of the rock. The only thing that can explain that is life. Probably a very simple type of plant life. It's being completely ignored by the scientists. This is why it's important for the public to understand that you're being lied to. I can only do so much. I have almost no resources whatsoever. All I ask is for people to help me out by spreading the message that Mars is alive. Take a look at one more thing. This might be a small plant. It might be a small rock. I can accept either one. And there we have it for this segment. More to follow. Check your news at 5. From Spirit Soul 39, a mystery object sits in the Martian landscape, curiously sticking up out of the ground. This one may be natural, of course. There's a good possibility of it. But it appears to be actually a machine-type object where we have pipes going through a narrow opening here and out into this section here. It appears to be a machine-type object, possibly a refrigeration unit or something similar. That would be my guess. But that's not even the most interesting object of the photo. Down here, we have a rectangular object which does not resemble a rock at all. It is apparently possibly some sort of a container. We don't know. We're not getting the answers that we need. Totally ignored by the press, of course. Over here, we have some more objects, including a mysterious opening. We had a lot of these mysterious openings in the photos. They appear to lead to underground structures of some sort. I believe that Martians did move underground at one time. They may still be living there. Then we have this rounded object here, which is not a sand dune and is not a rock. It may be a part of a complex again. The list of interesting objects just goes on and on. Here's another mysterious object. Very old, broken down, doesn't appear to be natural. So there we have more objects that, in the early days, continue to flummox me. I studied these photos for a long time. Eventually I started picking up on all the plants that are in them as well as the artifacts. In my early days I was more concerned with artifacts and then I started getting into the plants. One more object before we stop this one. Here we have an interesting object. We can't tell that much about it. This may or may not be natural, but it looks like we have a circular area here and rectangular slot inside here. Probably not natural. See, the Mars photos are packed full of mysterious objects like this. I'm not talking about one or two objects out of 1,000 pictures. No, we're talking about thousands of mysterious objects. Some of them identifiable, like pipes. Others not so identifiable. And this is the point. We need to demand truth because we're not being told it. No examination of the Mars photos will be complete without showing different anomalies that clearly show life. In this photo from Spirit Soul 50, we see an object sticking out from the surface of a rock. It appears that this is some sort of an unknown life form. Perhaps a plant, perhaps not. It would be difficult to tell without microscopic examination. One thing's for certain, it's extremely unusual for this to be on the surface of a rock, given that it's Mars. You would think the rock surface would be relatively smooth, yet this thing juts way out. Another example of ignored evidence. From Spirit Soul 55, another example of completely ignored evidence. Here in this little area, we can see where apparently two pipes heading underneath a sheath. What they're doing there, I don't know. And we have another sheath that sits up here almost as if this is some sort of a machine, mechanical device, something of that nature. And these are pipes that are going underneath it. It's hard to tell. Once again, this is another example of ignored evidence from the early days. Here we have kind of a rocker-like shaped object, and one or two other minor objects in the photo. And, you know, these shouldn't be ignored. But they are ignored. These people don't want to hear about artifacts and structures and plants on the surface of Mars. Okay, at the base of this rock, we see what are probably plants sticking up. Once again, more ignored evidence. It just goes on and on. And something else over here, and a little sprig sticking up here. It goes on and on. The evidence is beyond overwhelming. So what we need to do is show everybody what is there, and that's what I'm attempting to do. I'm going to move on to the next slide. This one didn't have a whole lot of evidence in it, just some. From Spirit Soul 59, we have two objects which are almost certainly unnatural. This one up here has kind of a squarish appearance and it appears to be hollow. This is another of those typical hollow Martian objects that abound in these photos. This one has an object coming down from its center. It's more rounded on the sides and dips a little on the top, and it has a fuzzy area sticking out from it, which means it's almost certainly encrusted by vegetation. So then we have more evidence that's been completely ignored, which should have been shown to the public a long time ago, but in much greater detail than what I can do. For a time, I mulled the idea of going down to the surface, even if I could figure it out. Was it safe to do this? Or would I get thrown into outer space by a teleport pad? I didn't know. But I decided to risk it anyway. Because staying here didn't accomplish anything, and I wasn't finding out what I needed to find out. I touched the pad. Waited. I got a message saying ground. I decided to risk it. After I arrived on the ground, I looked down and I noticed a strange rectangular object sitting on the Martian landscape. I decided, rather than try to investigate it here, I would take it back to the ship where I come from. So I decided I would pick it up and take it with me. I turned to the teleport pad again. Touched it. And decided with all due haste to go back to the ship. I was already getting used to this. I decided to take it up the ladder and put it on the conference table so I could examine it in greater detail. How could there be anything artificial on Mars? It ran contrary to everything I had ever been told. Still, I couldn't deny what I had seen. I sat down to examine the curious object. It was about the size of a bread box, with two hollow ends. It was definitely not natural. Who made it? Who were the architects of Mars who had made this object? It seemed every time I did something, I wound up with another mystery. Looking at this object, I realized that I was in for more than I had bargained for. Did I say I was in for a little adventure? Oh, I was in for much more than that. In the previous section, our explorer finds Spirit Soul 68. He actually picked up the model for it and took it to the alien spacecraft. This is the actual photo of the object. It's a rectangular object with a hollow area on each end and something sticking up there. And it has this wispy appearance on top, like these were cobwebs or something. Who knows what they actually are, I don't know. This is one of my most heavily studied objects. Literally hundreds and hundreds of hours of study on this one. There's no question that what we're seeing here is an artificial object. The question is, what was its function? It's setting up on a little platform or something here, like some sheet metal. So it's sitting at an angle. Right beside it, we have this apparently heart-shaped object, which resembles what? It's sitting not on the ground, but up in the air, which means something has to be holding it up. And if something's holding it up, it is almost certainly a stem. So we can conclude from that that what we're seeing here is a leaf. I think it's pretty obvious, actually, that this is a leaf. I'm going to move the cameras and try to show it. As we can see, it's well up off the ground, which rules out that this is any ordinary object. It certainly isn't a rock sitting on the ground, and not when you have this big shadow underneath it, and we can see the point here sticking into the ground. Now, more than likely, we're seeing a broadleaf plant there. I didn't do a model for this. We're going to go down and take one more look at the Spirit Soul 68 model, and see what we can find out about it. Okay, this is Spirit Soul 68 again. This is a smaller board that I put it on. I'm going to show one more thing that I missed earlier. We have beneath this boulder an unusual flat ribbon or something like it going from the extreme right of the photo on over to this object. This object has a rectangular opening in it. It appears that whatever this is attaches to it. Almost has the appearance of a ribbon cable. Where, like the ones that are used in computers. So we're left to guess as to what this is and what its function is. And again, another object, kind of rectangular right here. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this. I just want to show the model, and we're going to move along to another photo. We have so much ground to cover in so little time. This is a model again that I showed in the dramatic sequence. Never mind the notice there, I had to close that out. This is basic and simple. It's a box-like artifact. This is not hard to understand, except for what its function is, which I don't know. I didn't set this up on any piece of sheet metal or anything. I just wanted to display the basic artifact. And that's about it. We got a lot of ground to cover, and not much time to do it in. From Spirit Soul 63, one of the stranger objects you'll see is this one with this flap hanging down. Ordinarily, I would dismiss this as just being an ordinary rock, but the problem is that it has this flap hanging down, which cannot be dismissed as easily. And the flap is apparently attached. I count not one but two ropes, strings, whatever they are, holding that thing on there. There actually appears to be two of them. One of them goes away from the camera. And it's this type of thing that shows that we are not being told the truth about Mars photos. Once again, this is not part of the other object. I believe that it actually hangs down from projection from this object. Which means we're not looking at a rock, we're looking at some sort of an artifact. That would be my assessment of what I'm seeing. But it gets a little more interesting. Right here we have an object which casts shadow sticking way up. The odds against that being a rock are pretty good, I would say. There shouldn't be a rock just sticking up like that, although it could be. No question that it could be. So there's another object. Finally, we have these three objects. Could be natural, I suppose. But here we have more just incredible evidence that's being ignored. And it should be on the front page of the newspapers. We need to get action. We need to demand the truth. From Spirit Soul 59, the instances of ignored artifacts and structures and other things just continues to boggle the mind. In this photo, what we're seeing here is a cylindrical object which sticks up from the ground right here. It looks like it's contrasted against rock and sitting on a rock, but in fact it's free, and we can tell that is freestanding because we can see the shadow, so it can't be a part of that rock. Not only is it freestanding like that, but it has connections. You can clearly see a pipe connection to this object, which means it cannot be natural. The pipes themselves appear to be encrusted with vegetation, plus we have a separate pipe sticking up here coming out of this rock, which makes it questionable that we're even seeing rock at all. one thing's for certain, this is a tremendous anomaly, and never should have been ignored by the press, by NASA, and by everybody else. Now, here we have an object sticking up out of the ground, right near it. This is probably, I'm going to put this in my gray box for now, this is probably a plant sticking up. A leaf or flower or whatever. The reason I say probably is we're not seeing much of a shadow, and that's an indication that this may be an optical illusion. Still, another exciting example of artifacts that have been ignored and should have been talked about. From Opportunity Soul 88 comes one of the strangest photos in the Mars Exploration Rover gallery. I'm going to start with this bizarre object in the center of the picture. We have a number of different things. We have this rib that goes up and across, and presumably another one on the other side. And then we have this central rib here. This could almost legitimately be a carcass. I don't think that's what it is. But it does have the preliminary indications that it could be a carcass. You have these ribs coming off here. This is why I don't believe it is. These look more like veins of a large plant than they do animal ribs. And this is arguably a leaf, fed by the veins coming off the main rib. Down here we have another one that goes underneath. All in all, this is one of the strangest objects I've ever seen in Mars Exploration Rover photos. The far section, you really can't see it very well. I don't know what it is. There's kind of like a little horn coming off it. So we may be looking at two or more objects. In fact, there's a little plant growing up out of there. Now we're going to move on over and look at this object, which is actually quite similar. Seeing the same pattern of ribs, but coming off here, we see the plant lobes, leaf lobes, coming right off the central leaf. So I believe this is a very large broadleaf plant, fed by the water in the distance. That's right. This is almost certainly a pond. We're going to zoom back out. We can see the distortions of underwater objects. So I don't think it's very deep. You can see this right here, how we have this distortion and very long streak. So this, all in all, is one of the most fascinating photos I've ever seen in the Mars Exploration Rover photo gallery. But there's more. If we look up here, we can clearly see in this area what is essentially a small ground cover, like a grassy weed. There's no question what we're seeing. There's nothing to argue about. There's nothing to discuss. It's a plant. Notice how we have this rock in the center and it grows up all around it. It's unmistakable. And again, up here we can see the same pattern of a low grassy weed growing in the background. It's all over the place in this photo. There is nothing to debate here. Now we're going to move on down. I'm going to show a little bit more before we move on. In this area, we can see there are literally thousands of small stalks sticking up. And if you're sharp-eyed, you can see just a little bit of fuzziness right in here, and that's because we have small plants sticking up. I'm going to switch to another photo, and one where I've enhanced it. Switching back to opportunity photos for a while, I'm going to take a quick look at this photo. In the foreground here, we see the same creeping ground cover that I've seen in many other places. It's a very prolific weed, whatever it is. It's just too high of a concentration for this to be rocks. And the shapes are definitely those of leaves and stems. They're not of small, amorphous objects sitting on the ground. So just heads up there, more vegetation. I'm used to seeing it, it's not a big deal. And we're going to take a look at the other object that I'm interested in here. This appears to be a building structure of some sort. The architects of Mars seem to prefer flat roofs to some extent. I wouldn't know why. Of course, on the lower gravity, if it doesn't have as much precipitation, perhaps a flat roof is best. Well, just heads up, this is rectangular and then it has a pointed end on it. Not a good candidate for a rock at all. There appears to be something on top of it, like a turret. I'm not saying it's a weapon, I'm just speculating as to what that could be. And another one at the other end, so this really could be a weapon of some sort. And then there's another object right to the right of it. Plus, another possible structure right over here. So then we have some pretty good evidence that there's something wrong there. I don't know exactly what we're looking at. And we'll move on to the next one. Once again, from Opportunity Soul 103. Another view of the Martian grasses. Folks, I'm tired of the lies. You have not been told the truth. We have not been told the truth. You can see these sticking up around here. In this rocky area, it's over. There's nothing to discuss. I want to know where you people in the press are. You look at this photo, you can't possibly think that these are rocks sitting on the ground. It's not intellectually honest. No, sir. These are plants, and there's no two ways about it. And they are on Mars. Assuming, of course, that we're told the truth about where these photos come from. That's a whole nother discussion, and I believe we are. But, more to the point, here we have the grasses. It's blatantly obvious. It's unmistakable. And I don't need a scientist to tell me what grass looks like. No, I don't. If you scientists have the gall say that this is anything but grasses, then you should be locked up in a mental hospital. Because you have no right not to tell the public, look, we have Martian grasses here, we know they're plants, that's the end of the story. There's tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of stalks sticking up. It's over. This evidence proves everything that we've been saying. There is current life. This fuzziness, the way these stick up, cannot be explained by rocks on the ground. It is intellectually lazy. It is intellectually dishonest to say that it can. Here we see classic pattern right in here of grasses. I've had it. I demand action. We all have to demand action. You people in the press, get this on the networks, show the public, demand the truth from the government. Next segment. For opportunity, soul 103. Here we have tens of thousands of stalks sticking up. Heavy vegetation throughout this photo, with the exception right here in the middle, we have this large white rock, or whatever it is, sticking up. But all around it, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of stalks sticking up. This is a ground cover plant. There's nothing to discuss. Rocks cannot possibly account for this, especially not on the surface of a planet supposed to be swept by all these dust storms. No, no, no. It gets better as we go up. Here we have what is obviously no ifs, ands, or buts. No question, no arguing. A field of plants. This is a field of grasses similar to what you might see in an Earth photo, actually. There is nothing to argue about. Don't argue. Just accept it. These are plants and demand the truth. The public demands the truth. The public has to demand the truth. There is nothing to argue about here. We're seeing a field of grasses. I've seen it hundreds and thousands of times here on Earth. Not hundreds of thousands, but we all know. We see it every day. Sometimes I get a little worked up because I'm sick of the lies. And if you don't believe that, let's take a closer look at this. Here we have a skeleton-like object. It's not a skeleton, but what we're seeing here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, at least 6 different stalks sticking up. Similar to what you might have with an earth cactus, or possibly even a Joshua tree. I'm not saying that this is on Earth, it isn't. But there's no question that we're seeing a plant. Or an artificial object. There's one or the other. This isn't a rock. It cannot be called a rock. If you're going to call it a rock, then you're a liar. If you're going to call these hundreds of thousands of stalks sticking up, blades of grass, you're going to call those rocks, then you're a liar. It's as simple as that. This is, you know, all we need to see. We don't need any more proof than this. This, folks, is your proof. And there is no question. From Opportunity Soul 122, we get an idea of possibly some dam building techniques or something. I've always thought this appears to be a dam-like structure. It's in some crater, possibly an amphitheater at one time. And here we have tens of thousands of these small nodules that seem to grow on the rocks. I'm thinking these are some sort of Martian seeds. NASA claims that they're iron hematite particles, but they seem to have an affinity for rocks, and they seem to grow in there in high concentration. We have a little shelf that sticks out, and we're going to take a look at one object up top before we move on to the next plate. Here we have a bulb of something sticking up. Casts a big shadow, so we know it's for real. Just an unusual anomaly. Probably an artifact of some sort. And if we look really closely up in here, we can see how the rocks are occluded to some extent. There's vines growing vines and vegetation once again growing in this area, as well as an obvious pattern where apparently rocks put there by purpose. This is a very old area. Like I said, it looks like a dam or something, or for a reservoir, possibly an amphitheater. Maybe a dam for a reservoir would be closer. Next slide. Again, we're going to look at another example of Opportunity Sol 122. Same type of thing as before. This looks like rocks, stone slabs are put in place by somebody and have since started falling apart. There appears to be a flower sticking out of this area here. Other than that, we just have the same odd nodules everywhere growing on things. And right over here, I'm going to show a little bit more closely. We have a plant growing right there. You see how it's translucent. Rocks generally aren't translucent. Here's another one, a small leaf. Rocks are not generally translucent. And there's small plants and these strange nodules everywhere in this photo. There's too many of them to point them all out. Once again, this Opportunity Sol 122. A couple more instances of it show. There's a small plant sticking up. Right in here. They're all over the place. From Opportunity Sol 132. We have an interesting feature here. Looks like possibly a mine shaft. It's all broken down. This is kind of what I think it is. It looks like it goes deep into the ground. Other than that, I can't tell that much. This one's been kind of in my gray box. But here's an interesting thing right here. All we get is a silhouette of sticking up off the ground and it casts a shadow. So, we're possibly seeing a plant there or an artifact. Other than that, there's not too much in this photo. We have the usual grump, little nodules sticking up everywhere on the rocks and so forth. Classic opportunity photo. Not much to see, but interesting nonetheless. My faith in the official version of things came to an abrupt end when I saw this bizarre object from Spirit Sol 88. With its rectangular slots, and the fact that we have at least two or three cables, or perhaps vines running through this. This object cannot possibly be natural. In fact, based on slots alone, I estimated the odds to be 1.29 times 10 to the 25th power against its being natural. The debunkers were, of course, unmoved. Here we have yet another cable or stem. It's hard to tell what it is. We're going to take a look at a couple other objects. Then we're going to go down and take a look at the model I made for this. It's actually a simpler model than it should be. Here we have a couple of hollow objects, and behind them we have another one that is open, has a clear, obvious doorway. There's no way that object is natural. Yet the debunkers were unmoved by this. Then we move over here. We have what is apparently something similar to a Quonset hut. And another one here. Then another interesting object just kind of pointed at one end and then big at the other end. All these objects amount to an unbelievable wealth of information about Mars, but it's totally ignored by the press and totally ignored by mainstream scientists. These people have an agenda, and their agenda is simple. Mollify, pacify, lie, deceive, and don't tell the public what you know. Now we're going to move down and take a look at models that I created. This is one of my most heavily studied photos. Spirit Soul 88 was the only one where I've actually tried to recreate an entire scene. This scene isn't finished yet, but I bottled it up and packed it away for future use. And now we're going to res this scene and we're going to walk through it. This is Spirit Soul 88, unfinished model. This is my artist's conception, what I think it might have looked at, like, at one time. And like I said, it's not finished. I haven't shown the vines that actually run through this, up in this area. But you get this idea. This is not a natural object. But our mainstream scientists don't want you to understand that. If they did, they would have told you a long time ago. Here's a sign that I made for it. I'm attempting the unthinkable, recreating an entire scene. Spirit Soul 88 contains many strange and wonderful artifacts and plants. So far, I've only done the one model, which I will be updating. We're going to go through... This is that large object which I showed earlier. My little model doesn't do it justice, but I did the best I could. I'm not really an artist. I am somewhat of a Second Life builder. Over here are another couple objects I'm not finished with. A flat, rectangular, hollow object. This one caught my attention. And it goes on and on. Right here are small models of the little buildings that I showed earlier. Plus the conical one over here with the opening. That one's actually a pretty good model of what I'm seeing. Definitely not natural. And a possible piping, pumping system right here. Like I said, my faith in the system was completely shattered by this point. I knew that I was being lied to, that the public was being lied to, and these people have no right to do this. They have no right to sit there and tell us that Mars is a cold, dead world that might have had life on it at one time. Not when there are obvious artifacts and structures and so forth in Mars Exploration Rover photos. So, there is plenty to come. Because no one can sit here and be honest and tell me that everything I'm seeing is just rock. No. They are trying to mollify you, they are trying to pacify you, they are trying to control you. Just tell the truth. That's all we ask. For Opportunity Soul 104, this may be a structure. Frankly, this looks like some more pipes on the large side, as if this might be a construction area. That's in my gray box for now. This isn't one of the best photos by any means. Other than that, there's a small amount of vegetation everywhere. A classic Mars photo, we have small bush down here. Once again, I'm getting tired of the lies. Enough is enough. You people in the press, get off your rear ends and say something. That's it. From Spirit Soul 136, right down the edge of this photo, we have a hollow object, which vaguely resembles perhaps a discarded carton or something like that. Notice this very thin shell that's completely hollow. There's something inside it here, right on the edge. There's a sort of a wispy material. I don't think this is natural. You just don't find something like this in nature. Somebody created it. And it's got some sort of a projection up on top. This is a classic Martian object. I'm used to seeing them. Then look around. We have one more for this segment. This small, strange object. Don't know what it is. Probably not natural, once again. Possibly a small plant right here. So there you go. Another example of something built by the architects of Mars. From Spirit Soul 140, we have one anomaly here. Notice how it's open. There seems to be a knob or a bolt or something on top of it. It's very small. It's hard to see. This is classic Martian object. Hollow, split. And to close out a message there. We see this all the time in Mars photos. It's nothing unusual. It's not a rock. Then we see this opening right here. Another hollow anomaly, which I can't identify. And there's a third strange anomaly over here. I believe that this is a, not a coincidence. I don't believe in coincidences. I think these objects are related. But now I have a shocker, which I'm going to show, which is beyond belief. I'm going to move the cameras on over. This is a fairly easy to identify object, what we're seeing. We're seeing two pipes here, plus a third pipe that comes off the bottom pipe. These two pipes go off and go in and presumably attach to some mechanism inside. There's a bottom pipe and a top pipe. And possibly another one going up here. There's some kind of a covering here. And if you look really closely, you can see the open end of yet another pipe over here. This is not fantasy. This is reality. These are pipes on Mars. I don't need a scientist to tell me what a pipe is. I already know what one is. I have positively identified these as pipes. That's it. There's nothing more to discuss. They are pipes. End of subject. End of debate. All in all, a very strange, anomalous object. And something that the architects of Mars built. That's all for this one. Another Spirit Soul 140. One of several. Just one really interesting object here, hollow. It's got some sort of pipe in it again, a little mechanism. Classic Martian object. Not going to spend much time on it. You got a lot of ground to cover. But definitely not natural. And once again, I'm going to tell you scientists out there, I don't need you to tell me what a pipe looks like. I know what a pipe is. This is case closed. I know what it is. I've identified this object. At least what's inside it is a hollow object with a pipe inside it. That's it. End of subject. End of discussion. Another Spirit Soul 140. Another example of a hollow object. This is an anomaly. It's not natural. It was built by somebody. And it's just another example of something that was built, and it's on Mars. It's pretty much case closed as far as being artificial. And there's a pipe behind it. And over here, we have... I don't know how to describe this, these holes that appear to be unnatural. I don't know what... really to make of that anomaly. We're going to move along quickly though. From Spirit Soul 140 again, we have these hollow objects. They're like, they look like culverts, possibly drainage pipes, but they're not perfectly round like you'd expect a drainage pipe to be. I just want to show those quickly because they relate to what we're going to see at the bottom. In here we have a clear and obvious pattern of vegetation. Picture's a little washed out, but it's all over the place. Stems crawling all over the place. I love that line from the original War of the Worlds, the musical version. Wherever there was a stream, the red weed clung and grew with frightening voraciousness. Its claw-like fronds choking the movement of the waters. And then it began to creep like a slimy red animal across the land, covering field and ditch and tree and hedgerow with living scarlet feelers, crawling, crawling. That's kind of what this red weed in this place reminds me of. Okay, here's the main object, though. We have a hollow object. This is actually thin sheet metal. I believe this to be the hole. That's what it appears to be. This is right at the bottom edge of the funnel. And this hollow piece of metal is right on top of it. Notice how the lid sticks up at a 90 degree angle. And then it goes over here. It's hard to see the other edge. There appears to be an attachment point right here. And then, of course, another sheet of metal right here. So, there we have a clear indication of an artificial object. There is no question. There's nothing to argue about. There's nothing to debate. This is artificial. Once again, I don't need a scientist to tell me what sheet metal is. I already know what it is. And what we're seeing here is sheet metal. And possibly a hole that would lead to some system like a sewer system. I don't need a scientist to know what I'm looking at. You are not that important. This is case closed. It is an artifact. It is not natural. It was built by somebody. This is case closed. There's nothing to discuss. One more Spirit Soul 140, if I'm lucky. Okay, we're going to round out Spirit Soul 140 with this photo. Not much in it. We have one hollow object with something inside it here. We have an apparent waterway up here. That's what I'm thinking this is. Here we have the ground cover and very rocky ground, and all of a sudden we see this totally smooth area, and then it's the same on the other side. That's clear indication that we're seeing water. And you can also see just a hint of a reflection in some places in the water from the other side. So here we have a clear example of water in photo, which has been ignored by the press. Because they don't care. They're too busy telling you about single moms who kill their kids, and they don't talk about this type of thing. So there you have it. It's pretty obvious and clear that we're seeing water and artificial objects. We're going to move on to Spirit Soul 141, and at some point I'm going to have to get to some of the structures that are in the photos. From Spirit Soul 141, just a couple of minor anomalies. In a relatively heavily vegetated area. In order to see the vegetation, you can turn up the contrast on a photo and you'll see it, and bring down the lighting a little bit. They've intentionally washed these photos out. This is a rectangular object. Looks like a buried structure of some sort. It's not that uncommon to see a partially buried structure in Mars Exploration Rover photos. Right over here, follow the cursor, there may or may not be a skull here. It kind of looks almost like a skull and a pile of bones. Strange. We got one more anomaly to look at in this particular photo. Here we have just a solid object, which I can probably ignore except for one little problem. We have a streak. It appears to be translucent going into it. I'm at a loss to explain some of these translucent objects and streaks and so forth that you see in the Mars photos. It may well represent technology that we don't have here on Earth. It would be hard to tell without being able to physically examine. So that's about it for Spirit Soul 141. Here's another object with a rectangular slot in it. A little bit of an anomaly there. Once again, we're seeing things that are extraordinary. These are not ordinary objects. Okay, we're going to add just a little bit to Spirit Soul 141. A couple of anomalies I missed on my original run through. Right over here on the extreme right of the screen, we see something with a rectangular hole in it. Rocks don't have rectangular holes in it. And this appears to be a rectangular object right here. We have some sort of a manufactured framework there. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on it because I'm used to seeing them. Over here, we have another rectangular object, very dark. Perhaps this is a hole, I'm not really sure. And then up here, if we look really carefully, we have yet another rectangular area. And it's got some objects on top of it, like a framework here. Framework and lid, and then there's some objects inside of it. They're too small, too distant to be able to tell what they are. So then we have more anomalies, not natural, not rocks. Obviously, a sophisticated technology. So it's time that we got on the telephone and talked to our representatives and demanded the truth. I'm not sure even Congress knows the truth. The secrecy surrounding all this is just beyond belief. But there we have the anomalies once again. Spirit Soul 141. From Spirit Soul 147, we have a picture that's packed full of unusual objects. I'm going to take a look at the main one that I've done a model for, and we're going to go down below in a little bit, take a look at the model. Here we have what essentially is a hollow object. This is a classic hollow Martian object. I see these all the time. It seems to have a dish-like object hanging from the ceiling. So there we have a pretty good example of an artificial object on Mars. Here we have an object, looks like a pipe or a handle or something, almost looks like an axe. Just inside there, here we have one hollow object, here we have an anomaly that's kind of sticking up, almost a horseshoe type shape, vertically, another hollow object, and another. This whole photo is packed full of strange objects. I haven't made any other models, which is unfortunate, and I'm thinking I just might. Let's take a look at this strange object. It almost looks like fabric stretched over some sort of framework. It's all broken down. I don't think this is a regular rock. It's got me rather puzzled as to what it is. It's kind of hollow and kind of ripped open on the end there. So there we have an anomalous mystery. There's another object here I'm going to point out, if I can find it. Bear with me. It looks like a skull. Perhaps of a large bird. I don't know, but it has all the appearance of a skull. It's been sitting there for some time. Notice the elongated snout or beak. This is a very strange object. Probably natural, but the question is it a skull? My thinking is it probably is. Alright, one or two more things before we go down below. More hollow anomalies and other things. There's a possible plant leaf. If you see a flat, kind of pointed object and it's raised up off the ground, odds are it's a plant leaf. That's about it for this photo. I'm going to take it downstairs. We're going to look at the model next. Okay, we're down in the main display room. What we have here is the photo and the model from Spirit Soul 147. The object is in the red square, obviously. I just put a back on that. I didn't do the whole model. I was having difficulty accounting for the shape, so I just wanted to illustrate this is a hollow object with a apparent dish hanging from the top of it. And that's all, really, for Spirit Soul 147. You got a lot of stuff to cover. Thank you for your kind attention. We'll move on to the next photo. From Spirit Soul 152, we have this unusual object over here. It features something with a rectangular slot in it, and then two pipes leading to the object. In the background is this hollow object that sticks up. Very strange, very unusual, and very not natural. And this is typical of Mars photos, although I usually don't see pipes sticking out of these things. That's the unusual part as far as that goes. A couple other things. Hollow object there. Nothing unusual for the Mars photos. And we'll go up. And see if we can find anything else while we're right at it. There's one anomaly off to the side. There's a triangular piece. And it has... It's like a triangular donut, if there was such a thing. Another interesting item right here in the corner. I'm going to move it over so we can get a better look. Looks like a small object with a pipe coming off it. Once again, this is not natural. And then we have yet another object here, which again has a manufactured hole in it. This is a manufactured object. And finally, another one of those possible culverts with a drainage hole in it. See that a lot in Mars photos. So there we have a number of anomalies. Even in a picture, it doesn't look like initially it has anything in it. When you get into it and study it well, you find out differently. Here in Spirit Soul 154, we have a few more anomalies. A little on the odd side. We have this one right here is a hollow object. Typical of the Martian photos. There's an odd looking object right there. And another classic hollow Martian object. I have never seen so many hollow objects, not even here on Earth. It simply is not normal for natural objects to be hollow like that in such profusion. And here we have what appears to be some sort of a device. There's an outside chance this could be just a natural rock formation, but I don't believe so. It doesn't appear to be. Another one of those small Martian hollow objects. It's just incredible how all this evidence can be ignored. Follow the cursor, I'll move it over. Here kind of an odd little object there, just an anomaly. Nothing I'm going to study in any detail. And that's about it. The evidence is beyond staggering. But we need the public to demand the truth. Otherwise, you're not going to get it. You're being lied to. There is no question in that. Okay, this rock may have imprint of a fossil right there. Fossilized plant. Don't know. So we're going to go ahead and go to another photo. We've got a lot of ground to cover and not much time to do it in. From Spirit Soul 156, we've seen a structure sitting on a hillside. An interesting structure. It's got a flat roof, rectangular, and probably some vegetation growing on top of the roof. The interesting part is that this casts shadows underneath it. So we can see that there is a structure there. And it's not sitting on the ground. So there's yet another strange anomaly. An artifact of a possibly long dead civilization. Or maybe they're still around. We don't know. Finally, in this series, we have Spirit Soul 1. 61. This is a remarkable photo. Here we have yet another one of the vent hoods, the hollow objects. And if we can find it, I'm going to show another one up here. Another hollow object. Mars photos are just loaded with those, and I don't have an answer as to why. Other than I think they may lead to structures underground. But here, we have what appears to be a hollow structure of some sort. It's old and broken down. It kind of reminds one of old adobe structures in the southwest United States. I'm going to look at one more object before we go from this segment. This, at first, doesn't look like much until we look a little closer. First of all, it has I hesitate to use the word a stick. It has a rod or something sticking out. We have a square object inside here that the rod sticks out from. Much of this is hollow. And then we have what used to be a round hole, possibly to a chimney or something, right here. So this is beyond belief that anybody can ignore this evidence. This is not a natural object. No, no, no. Then we have this hollow object up above it. And, as a bonus, I'm going to show what is apparently a roof to a partially submerged structure, submerged under the ground. We have the roof, and then we have the structure. It's actually pretty cut and dried. We have a building there. I wish I could examine it in person, but of course I can't. That's all for now. And we'll start on a new sequence of photos. When I first saw this object, I thought it was a helmet. That turned out not to be the case, however. This is Spirit Soul 211. And what we have here is basically a hollow object. It kind of slopes down on the sides, but other than that, it appears to be rectangular. What's on top of it is a whitish, translucent cable or something else. Series of cables. I can't really be sure. It may even be plant growth. Going from the top down to the side. I don't think it's plant growth in this case, however. It appears to be more artificial than anything else. This is a simple object. And very hard to identify if you don't have much in the way of resolution. Like I said, at first I thought it was a helmet, but that turned out not to be the case. I now know that we're seeing an artificial object with what appears to be plant growth growing from it. We're not talking about one object here anyway. We have the core object, and then we have the rest. And they're different colors. So this is not a rock or anything similar. The debunkers, of course, were unmoved. From Spirit Soul 317. We have objects that are beyond bizarre, starting with this one. Notice how it sits on the ground, stands upright, and appears not to be settled into the soil, which means it's been moved. And fairly recently, I would say. Down here, we have a clearly obvious leaf, where you can see partly through it, which means it's translucent or even a bit transparent. That's not a rock. Now we're going to move up. This whole photo is infused with plants, and it's hard to tell sometimes the difference between a legitimate rock and a plant. There's a plant leaf, however, that one's pretty easy. Here's another one sticking out of the ground. Well, we have two interesting objects up here. One is a pipe on the right. I don't need a scientist to tell me what a pipe is. I already know what one is. Another is this round object with a big rectangular hole in it. I don't need a scientist to tell me that's not natural. Much of the rest of this appears to be vegetation. This is not fantasy, folks. You're seeing life and artifacts on a distant alien world. And it's time we are told the truth. We're going to add something quickly to Spirit Soul 317. Right here in the bottom right-hand corner of the picture appears to be a skull. See the mouth open and two eyes. This is either a skull or perhaps a statue of an animal or even a living animal. I don't know. But it's not a normal rock, whatever it is. Then above here, we have one pipe. Another pipe sticking up and out here. Another pipe sticking up and out here. Three pipes easily visible in the Mars Exploration Rover photo, in addition to the one up at the top. More evidence of an ancient civilization. Though the gravity was lower than that of Earth, we still had to struggle to bring this object up from the surface. I marveled at it and wondered what function it might have served at one time. It was just amazing. Why had the Earth people never been told? And who were the builders of these objects? I looked around it. I guess my answers would have to wait. I thought I saw structures in the distance. I decided to go back down to the surface and take another look. This is Spirit Soul 537, and in this photo, we can clearly see not one or two, but many buildings with obvious windows in them. Here we have one with two circular holes. It almost looks like a face or a skull. I'm tempted to call this the Valley of the Skulls, but I think these are buildings in reality. Over here's another one. And you got more and more. There's a small building with two windows. And there are more buildings all over the place in this photo. Usually with just two windows, no more, no less. You can see the portals right here. They're all over the place. This is not natural. These are not natural rocks or anything like that. And again, here we have a much larger example of a building with windows. Partially occluded, but they're windows nonetheless. This is not natural. And cannot be called natural. And again, another object right here on the right. We're going to move over. It's got a window or a doorway. And up on the hill, buildings with peaked roofs. There's nothing to argue about here. We are seeing buildings. And over on the right-hand edge, the image of what appears to be a farmhouse or something similar. There's nothing to argue about here. You're seeing buildings. Here, we have something where this projection goes under and inside of this object. This represents technology, folks. No question. And we have this round sphere over here. Once again, that's not typical of a large rock. What you're seeing is technology. We're going to wrap up fairly soon the Architects of Mars. But it's going to stretch into at least two parts. Because there's so much evidence to go through. And we need public's help. We need the public to demand the truth. Look at this object. Hollow. Metallic. No question, it's not natural. From Spirit Soul 561, we have one of the more remarkable photos that I've seen. We're going to start with this building here. It's kind of a rounded shape. It's got one pipe that seems to come out of the side of it. Another possibly wraps around and goes in this big opening. Opening slopes down. I don't have a model made for this. I'm going to have to sooner or later, I suppose. We have a series of what appears to be related buildings. I believe this to be, to have been an industrial complex. It isn't anymore, probably, but that's what it was, in my opinion. And we look over here, what we have is essentially vines growing on top of everything. This is secondary vegetation that's taken over the area. Vines, bushes, they start up here and go over across this structure right here. There's no natural mineral or anything like that that can account for that. There's no rock. So, there we have another example of ignored evidence. And small bush here. But I want to show something really remarkable, if anybody can pick it up. And this one's tough. Right now, because it's very small. But if we look at this large rock, and we move to the left of it, there's a small object here, and out of this object is coming about five or six different stems. These are branches or stems or something from an obvious bush. Probably one that's dead. I mean, you see this here on Earth all the time. It may not show up in this copy, so those of you who want to look at this later, find the big object and just move to the left of it and see if you can bring that out. NASA, if we could bring something like that out, NASA would have an awful lot of explaining to do. Alright. And we're going to move over. Very heavily vegetated area. It seems to be small trees and bushes throughout the area on this hillside. And let's look down here. In this area, there appears to be some broadleaf plants. I've studied this area in some detail. It's a real tough case. It doesn't look right. It doesn't look like rocks. I believe much of it is plants. Like I said. So we have all these broadleaf, they're like pointed leaf plants, almost arrow-shaped. Those seem to be a fairly common plant on Mars. It's all through this little area. So I just wanted to point that out. Somebody with better equipment should be able to bring that out and show people the truth. And here's kind of a vehicle-shaped object. Looks like it's been all burned out. No good anymore, obviously. And there's a circular object here which may be a tire. Or rim, I should say. So, that's going to suffice. Spirit Soul 561 has enough objects in it for scholars to study for years. And that's just one photo. We need your help. We need you, the public, anybody who has better equipment. We need to show the truth on these objects. I'm only one person. I have no resources. I have no money. All I can do is struggle along the best I can. All I'm asking is for those of you who care about the truth to help show the public and demand an end to the information embargo. Demand an end to the cosmic Watergate. And demand the truth. I'm Artifacts of Mars. From Spirit Soul 669 comes a photo with an incredible amount of evidence in it for artificial objects on Mars. I call this a twin pipes photo because it contains not one but two sets of twin pipes. The first set is the most obvious one at the cursor. This is a twin set of pipes inside a jacket of sorts. The jacket seems to peak at the top and it has a rib on it. And then these pipes are nested inside there as if this is some sort of a manifold. A very, very unusual object. And absolutely, these are pipes. And they are on Mars. Question is, why? Okay, the second set of pipes isn't far away from it at all. You can see these here. They're much smaller and more difficult to see. But they're, once again, they're definitely pipes. This is why I call this twin pipes photo. And right below the first set, we have this object here, which looks like a metal rod or something similar. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on it. Up here, we have a whole plethora of objects that don't look right. Many of them look like cones. I believe we have some, once again, metal rods. And we have this unusual object here that has some sort of a proboscis sticking out of it. I'm not too familiar with that word, but it just sticks right out of it right there, and what it is, I don't have any clue. Over here, we have another object that looks like a pipe with a flange on it. And that's what I'm assuming this is. It gets too fuzzy if you get too close, so I'm just going to have to leave it at that. Point here is that it's not natural. Unless it's a type of flower. Which I don't have any information on. Now we're going to take a look at the main object, because this is the most interesting one. Not only does it have these two hollow openings here and possibly a third down here, but it's what's on top of it that's remarkable. Because on top of it, here we have the greatest proof I've ever seen in Mars photos. What we have is a rectangular metal plate with a metal loop on it, like what you might attach a lock to. Nature did not create this, folks. No way, no chance, no how. If somebody says nature created it, they are lying. It's as simple as that. Humans create metal plates with the loop on it for attaching locks and things. Nature doesn't. It's that simple. There's nothing to debate. There's nothing to argue about. It is not natural. This is game, set, match, and tournament. Game over. That's it. Up here we have a whole plethora of artificial objects. Mostly hollow objects, small ones. I'm not going to give them any individual attention at all. But that's about it. I haven't done any models for this one. I'm going to eventually, especially for the twin pipes. And here we have another object, obviously artificial, with one flap here, another square flap there. They're all over the place in this photo. I could spend a year just studying this photo. Okay, just to recap, two obvious pipes here. I've told you scientists out there before, I don't need you telling me what a pipe is. I already know what it is. Those are pipes. Case closed. And of course, the main object with this lock device or whatever it is, plus there's an additional device on top of it. Definitely not natural, definitely created by somebody. And then the small twin pipes here. All in all, this photo is one of the most egregious examples I've seen of artificiality. And just one little extra in the corner here. A curious object, circular, and you can see how this is open right here. I don't know what to make of that yet. I haven't studied it enough. This whole photo is just flooded with stuff. And well deserving to be included in this documentary. Thank you. Meanwhile, in my wanderings, I had stumbled upon a small structure. It was obvious now that there had been a civilization on Mars. But who built them? Were they the same people who brought me here? Or was it my own government? I really didn't know. I decided to continue investigating to see if I can find out what. I knew that it wasn't over by any means. I knew there was more than I was expected to find. What would happen would shake me to my core, as if that hadn't even happened already. To be continued.